Huntsville's Marshall Space Flight Center is one of NASA's biggest field offices, employing thousands of people. The teams at Marshall are charged with solving some of spaceflight's most complex technical problems.
That's right. I visited a Marshall facility, and here's how NASA is planning to use materials found on the moon for future construction in space.
Huntsville's deep roots in the space program continue to grow as NASA prepares to return to the moon and eventually venture to Mars. It's a collaborative process involving hundreds of outside contractors, and it all culminates here at Marshall Space Flight Center.
We're home to about 20 different chambers. We've got a vertical loading chambers, we've got horizontal chambers. We've got a clean room where we can process hardware that's...
You're taking a look inside the environmental test facilities at Huntsville's Marshall Space Flight Center. It's home to the thermal vacuum chamber V20, capable of recreating the extreme conditions NASA technology will face in space.
Air circulating all the time, it kind of dissipates heat. We don't have that on the moon.
And that's the next destination, putting astronauts back on the lunar surface.
And liftoff of Artemis 1.
One mission at a time.
Back to the moon and beyond.
But unlike past landings, we want to set up infrastructure for a longer stay.
Things like landing pads, blast shields to go around the landing pads, roads, habitats, shelters, and other pieces of infrastructure that may benefit from foundations there.
But even as NASA and its partners are building the most powerful rocket ever launched, it's still time-consuming and expensive to transport heavy items to the moon. So they began looking for a sustainable alternative, one that's readily available on the lunar surface.
If you want to take the regolith materials, they're basically just minerals like we have here on Earth, and we can take those materials and basically dissolve them up and free the oxygen and the different metals that make them up. So we could use oxygen for things like, you know, breathable air or propellants, and then we have metals that we can use for, say, manufacturing processes.
NASA's Moon to Mars Planetary Autonomous Construction Technology, or the IMPACT project, as it's known to those working at Marshall, is focused on lunar surface construction, both big.
What we found in developing this process is that it produces actually a very strong material that's suitable for landing pads. We've done tests and we've shown that it can take the heat loads from an engine of a spacecraft that's landing on it.
And small.
If we need to make a wrench or something because somebody lost it, dropped it on the surface, whatever, we can fabricate that on site.
Week by week, the team at Marshall Space Flight Center tests this new technology, studying how it will react when we launch it into space.
Constructing something on the lunar surface is actually feasible. All the work that we've done, so just need to go do it.
20 years ago, it seems like that would be an impossible mission. Here we are.
It's possible. Exactly.
Reporting in Huntsville, Kayla Smith, News 19.
Once this technology is established on the moon, NASA plans to bring it to Mars.